Our SportsNOAA.com trivia question of the evening surrounds the Saints defense, which did not yield a touchdown to the Vikings. And before that occurred, when was the last time the Saints kept an opponent out of the end zone? Tampa Bay, Brian Ellie Walsh, 41-0 Saints, December 16th, 2012. BAW was the man on the spot. He nailed this one. I didn't have a clue. Way to go, Brian. You're not too old yet. You still got game. I'm proud of you. Nice job. As Sports NOAA TV continues on WHNO, we continue by doing what we always have fun doing, and that is putting Brian on the hot seat. I had to mute him for a second because he's going to talk forever here momentarily because we had an occurrence in the NFL Sunday that clearly points to something that has to be discussed. Once again, this involves the game at Seattle with Denver and the Seahawks and the overtime rules. Should the overtime rule be changed yet again after watching a team win a toss, get the ball, and the other team sits and watches hopelessly without getting a shot? Brian, should there be a change? The floor is yours.
Thank you, Dr. Trahan. Absolutely, and yesterday's game brought this to the forefront. Perhaps I'm a little colored in my thought process because Peyton Manning was the one that was disallowed from getting a chance to move his Broncos into a position to tie or win the game. But absolutely, the whole idea is you want to make it a competitive game. And as it turned out, a flip of the coin, all right, determines who got the ball, and then Seattle did what the rules say. You go down and score a touchdown, you win the game. Other team doesn't get the ball. However, that said, I still think that the other team should get its hands on the ball. If Seattle scores, give Denver at least a chance to tie it, win it, extend the play, but they need to be given a chance to touch the ball and have a chance. And I think that's the real reason why they did this in the first place. You want to make it competitive, okay, but give the other team a chance.
Oh. It's professional football. I mean, they got a thing going on in college where they give the kids a chance to score, and keep the game going. They go three overtime. Professional football, you get the coin toss, you go down and stop them. Let them get a field goal, you get the ball back. They get a touchdown, they win. Game over with. And that's the way it goes. I mean, it's professional, it's not college. You don't keep, these guys, we don't have 100 guys out there. They only got 50-something guys out there every week. So, I mean, you can't get these guys out there all night to get hurt, Brian, on three or four overtime. I mean, you got a game the next week. So it ain't like college. College got 100-something guys. They can, you know, protect those guys a lot better.
Well, then
that's why they have it like that.
Tell the owners not to turn it into an 18-game regular season if that's the whole idea here, all right? The whole idea is that you want to give each team a fighting opportunity to win a game.
You got that.
And when you don't give them the ball, if you deny them a chance to get the ball, Ricky, that's not competitive spirit.
Denver had a whole chance to stop them from getting any points the whole game.
Well, Seattle did too, for that matter.
That's the way it goes, Brian. They got the ball last, and they did what they had to do to win the ball game.
I understand the way
next
the,
week.
I understand the way the rules
next
are
week,
written.
Denver won't let it happen next week.
I understand the way the rules are written, but my point is that they need to rewrite the rules to incorporate where each team gets an opportunity to touch the ball, regardless of touchdown, field goal, whatever.
That's what I like about the NFL. They got some great rules.
No. Well, look, and again, I may be colored in my thoughts, okay, because I think Peyton Manning, and look, he stood up at the podium and he gritted his teeth, and he wanted an opportunity. You know?
Yeah,
anybody that's a competitor opportunity.
I take my hat off to Denver. Man, they showed some offensive plays last night that kind of, I haven't seen in a long time. Seattle haven't seen. They had a backdoor slant, I mean, last night, three times. It was wide open. I mean, he missed it one time, but all night, Seattle never did get ready for that play. So, I mean, you know, you got to take your hat off to Denver. But, you know, they came up a little short. They got a two-point conversion. You know,
right.
So they did a lot of things to stay in the ball game. And then, with a minute or something, for Peyton to go down and get that touchdown, I thought the game was over with. So that shows you, man, that this guy got a lot of fire left.
80 yards he did on an elite defense, right?
A minute,
okay,
or
yeah,
much.
Yeah. Without any timeouts,
right.
I believe.
But you know what? They had a play that Denver hadn't seen, and it just shocked them. I mean, and they run it three times straight. They never did get ready for it.
Well, Let's render a judgment here because it's a very good debate. And I think both gentlemen make lucid points and I understand them both. Having said that, everything is reactionary. We saw the reactionary actions of Roger Goodell and the NFL as a whole after all the domestic abuse situations that we witnessed over the past few weeks, and they looked really bad in their reaction. And I think their reaction to the whole overtime thing stems back to what transpired in the playoffs, NFC Championship game, New Orleans Saints, Minnesota Vikings, Mercedes-Benz Superdome, went in overtime, the Saints won the toss, got the ball, went down, and kicked a field goal to go to the Super Bowl. And poor Brett Favre, as Ricky said, he didn't get a chance with the ball. And as a result, the rule changed. Why? Reactionary. Because Brett Favre, an iconic figure, never got the football. Peyton Manning, an iconic figure, never got the football. Listen, I believe this. I believe that in the NFL, because of the nature of the way the game is played, you play it like football. They do things the right way in this sense. They make you play football, unlike college, where they give you the ball at the 25 and say go score as much as you can, or in high school where they give it to you at the 10 and say go score as much as you can. At least they're playing football. That said, I think each team deserves the ball one time in overtime. After that, sudden death. You deserve the opportunity. Why wouldn't you get the chance? You got the equal chances during the game. You kicked off to start the game. They kicked off to start the second half. What's the difference? The flip of a coin with a backup player out there calling heads or tails, wearing number 7? Lucky number 7? Come on now. We can do better than this. Give them both a chance and then go sudden death. It can't be that difficult. It doesn't matter who the quarterback is, if he's iconic or if he's Trent Dilfer. When we return in just a moment, we'll talk college football, LSU, Tulane, and more as Sports NOAA TV continues.